everybody. Welcome to Denver, Colorado, the Mile High City, along with Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Just moments away from puck drop, Ray Ferraro's down at ringside. What are you keeping an eye on here for tonight?
Both teams want to get their defense up into the rush. Man, it must be way more fun being a defenseman these days than the stay-at-home of years past. Now your D have to be up and layer the attack.
Both teams are lined up, and we are set to get things going. The Wild have won the opening faceoff and take possession here at the start. Puts it on net. Couldn't light the lamp on that. What a chance.
Sometimes the puck just doesn't go where you want to finish it. He makes a good shot, but he can't capitalize.
Played big in the moment there. The Avs move to the offensive zone. Long reach breaks up the momentum. Receives the pass. The Avs get a hold of the puck in the open ice. Well, a challenge being laid here.
Spurgeon's ready to go. Apparently, the other guy doesn't want anything to do with him.
And that one's broken up. The Avs scoop it up along the boards. Slides it over to Burakovsky.
Line change.
Takes the feed. Here he is in front.
Whoa.
Scores! Nathan MacKinnon!
The good thing he one-times this puck. The goalie almost gets there, but the pass is on his tape in the low slot, and he beats him clean.
The Avalanche have made their way back to center ice with a 1-0 lead here early in this opening frame.
I like what I'm hearing from their bench, James. They're not talking about protecting the lead. They're talking about going and getting another.
Takes it to the net. Good heads-up play in the defensive zone. And he loses both the puck and his balance after that hit. Brodin's taking it from his own end. Slides the cross-ice pass. They gain the offensive zone from the middle. Puck grabbed by Greenway. Great stick work as he pokes it away. He got all of that hit on the play. Minnesota's got a hold of it against the wall. Here's a shot. Stopped by the goaltender.
Dumba's able to use a really good angle to cut the ice off, and he lays a solid hit against the boards.
Still a lot of time left in the period as we approach the midway mark. We got a 1-0 game to this point. Rask's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone. And it's a quick pass to Johansson. Comes up with the stop. Girard's caught with the hook and the official saw it. And now he angles it across to Donskoy. They've got numbers. Time for the official to pass down his sentence.
Well, the official's going to give him 2 minutes to think about that one.
Yeah, you can argue for a few seconds, James, I guess, but you already know at this point you're going to sit down.
Colorado sent in their power play unit out for the first time tonight.
Well, here's their first power play of the game. You'd love to score on your first one if you get the chance, because that helps the power play become more confident. More confident always means more successful.
Handles the puck. Branton and stick handling in his own zone. And couldn't find the intended receiver on that one. Moves the puck. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Here's a chance right in the slot. Denies him in front.
Sometimes you're in close. There's no room to put it anywhere. The goalie smothered it all. Well, what a quick reflex stop that is. Great scoring chance.
Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. Scoops up the puck off the draw. Gets it out of his own end. The Avs gain control of the puck against the wall. Colorado's got it in their own zone. Nice pass. Moved out in front. The Wild have possession shorthanded. The Avs fail to capitalize on the man advantage. Both sides back to even strength.
The only positive for the power play there is they didn't have to skate up and down the ice. They didn't generate anything. They had it in the zone, but really nothing very good about it.
Colorado's got it now. The Wild have possession along the boards. Tries to feed it over to Rask. Minnesota's got the puck against the boards. On the doorstep, pucked away from danger. Wrist one.
He scores!
What an effort to get this game back to level. You've got to continue to work even when you trail in the game. They did that, and now they have a brand new game to play. He's tight to the net. He doesn't have much time. And that snapshot beats the goaltender from the low slot.
More than half the frame has been played here. We got a tie game. Minnesota's won the draw in the neutral zone. Couldn't make that one happen. Grabbed along the boards by Brodin. The Avs take possession in the neutral zone. Quick pass to Nichushkin. Couldn't find the intended target. Sends a pass over. And player hauled down to the ice. Looks like we got a tripping penalty coming up here. Let's get the official decision. Tripping is the call. Did he sell or is that the right one in your mind?
I think it's the right one. He looks like he's picking up speed and the stick gets into his feet.
Minnesota's man advantage unit will take to the ice for the first time tonight.
Their first power play of the night. They've worked on it. It starts with the faceoff. Win the draw. Start moving the puck quickly before you shoot it.
And he feeds it down to Jost. Answered the call on that play. And that one's broken up. Great block there.
I wanted another look at this one. I'm sure you guys were all impressed as I was. What a save by the goalie.
Getting into the later stages of this period, it's all tied up. Bonino's won the draw here in the offensive zone. Centering pass, and a stick in the lane ends that threat. And he denied that opportunity. Slides the puck ahead to Graves. Belmar's carrying it ahead. And he's tripped up on the play. Referee's hand goes up here. And let's see what the call is. Spurgeon's off to the box. 2 minutes for tripping.
Always a little careless to get a tripping penalty. You get your stick into the player's feet. And when he goes down, you're going to go to the box.
Puck set to drop. We've got some 4-on-4 coming up.
We always talk about whether faceoffs are important or not, James. 4-on-4, they are. You want that initial possession.
Takes the pass. Rocks him. Colorado's got the puck along the boards. The Avs will have a chance to go to work here on the man advantage after the penalty expired. And now it's grabbed by McKinnon. Snaps it onto the net. Scores!
The deadlock's broken. That's a big goal, and they put him into the lead. Up to this one, James. He's looking behind the net where the puck is. Everybody else forgets about what's in front of the net. That's the dangerous player.
The Avs continue to lead here by one in the first.
This is a good start for them. They've got the early goal, and teams love to play from ahead.
Bjugstad's one possession. Goal. Quick feed to Fiala. With possession along the wall. Great save by the goaltender on that redirect.
Sharp reaction save.
Taken along the wall by Parisi. Puts it wide.
He wants to get rid of that puck as quickly as possible. He wants it as tight to the post as he can, but he just misses.
The Wild have gained possession off the wall. Slides it quickly to Spurgeon. Sends the pass over. That's a solid hit. There's the horn ending the first period. It went back and forth, and it's a close one here.
It's time for our hamburger bonanza. If the home team scores in the next 2 minutes, you can get a free hamburger courtesy of our arena.
As both teams get a breather, so will we. We'll take a quick pause for the cause. Teams are back at center ice, and we are ready to get period number two underway. Bjugstad's won the draw here in the open ice. Hot knock loose in the neutral zone. The Avs have it against the wall. Uses the force on that hit. Right up the gut into the attacking zone. That knocks it off the puck. In front, and a stoppage on the play as the goaltender covers things up.
He clearly thought he had room to get by, but it got closed off in a hurry. He took a big hit there.
Minnesota's had the scoring opportunities. They just haven't been able to capitalize as they continue to trail. They take possession as he locks them up off the faceoff. Fiala's got it in the defensive end. And now it's over to Parisi. Pokes it away to stay on the attack. The Avs take it from the side. Shot! And he makes the save. Spurgeon's lugging the puck. Moves it to Suter. Pushes it across to Fiala. Moving into the attacking zone. Puck scooped up by Parisi. Oh, gets a paddle on it. What a stop by Grubauer. The Avalanche have control of the puck. Colorado's got it in their own zone. Moves the puck across to MacKinnon. Colorado's got it along the wall. Picked up along the boards by Saad. And he totally whiffs on that one from the top of the offensive zone here. Skates across the blue line. Pokes it away in his own end. The Avs move the puck in the defensive zone. The Wild have taken possession in their own end. Moves it to Eriksson Ek. Play whistled dead because of an offside.
This is so frustrating. You make a good shot, you beat the goaltender, and you don't get rewarded. It hits too much of the post and stays out.
Minnesota's been the busier team offensively with way more shots on goal, but they still trail in the second. Takes the feed. Shuts him down. Now a quick pass to Cole. Oh, they telegraph the pass, and he picks it off. Takes the puck at the point. The Avalanche have taken possession along the wall. Unleashes a cannon, and he stands tall in goal. Hammers it on net. Too much traffic in the lane. Drills them. From the point, they take control of it. Here's a short pass to Johansson. Moves the puck along the half wall. Moves it quickly over to Rask. And that one's stopped. Slides the puck over. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Donskoy. Taken by Graves. Colorado's looking to break out of their own end. Here they come up along the wing. Nichushkin's going to play it against the half wall. Let's it fly. And that one's turned away. Scrum along the boards as they battle for the puck. Picked up along the wall by Suter. Receives the pass. And now he moves it quickly to Hartman. Pokes the puck away. Grabs it in his own end. Slides the puck to Hartman. The Avs have a hold of it in the defensive zone. Keeps hold of the puck. sends it deep inside the offensive zone. Officials blow the whistle. We got icing on the call.
Now, nothing too smooth about that play. The replay will show us that he's in good position and makes an excellent stick save to turn away a really good scoring chance.
Minnesota's had a lot of good looks offensively, but they have run into one hot goaltender, which is why they trail late in this second. Here he is in close. Big save.
That's in a dangerous spot. He makes a good save here.
Quick pass to Eriksson Ek. Cross ice pass. Comes up with the stop. Breaks up the pass in the defensive zone. Here's an odd man rush. Lugs the puck into the offensive zone corner. Can't connect. Manages to hang on. The Avalanche have the puck against the boards. Maintains possession. Smart defensive play here in the open ice. Quick feed to Spurgeon. And now it's to Greenway. Good defensive stop with the poke check. Colorado's looking to break out. And he slides it quickly to Jost. And he slides it quickly to Parisi. With the stop.
Grubauer's done it again. Another terrific save. And he's kept this game close.
Period comes to an end, and lucky us, we've got one more period to go in what has been a fun one this evening.
Hey kids, don't forget, if you're a member of our rookie team, you'll have the opportunity to have a couple of our players sign autographs after the game.
And we'll be right back for what should be a very intriguing third. They're ready to drop the puck on period number three. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Let's do this. Barring extra time, the final frame of this one. Here we go. Third period is underway. Feeds it down low. Moves it to Bjugstad. No room for that one to get through. Reads the play and forces the turnover. The Avalanche have gained control of the puck along the wall. Nice zone entry from the middle. Pass right on the doorstep, and they can't convert on the play. Takes the feed. And it's a quick pass to Fiala. And a poke check knocks the puck away. Hard blast, and that shot gets caught in traffic. Scooped up along the wall by Saad. Lifts the stick and takes the puck. Gives them nothing in front. And down he goes as the puck goes free. Here's a short pass to Saad. Colorado's got the puck against the half wall. Trying to get back on the attack now. And the puck skips out of the zone. They'll have to regroup. Moves it quickly over to Taves. The Avs looking against the half wall. Pass right in front, and they can't connect. Grabbed along the boards by Girard. Knocked away. Through the middle of the ice, they enter the attacking zone. Quick feed! Here he is, shot right in front! He was locked in there.
Grubauer's made an excellent stop here. He follows the puck and shuts down the scoring chance.
Minnesota's got to be frustrated with how things have played out tonight, trailing in this third period. Eriksson Ek won the draw. And a great save! Grubauer's got it, and he'll elect for the whistle.
Jumped on it pretty quickly there, and like everything else tonight, he's really looked in control. He's had an excellent game.
Still lots of time left here in this frame. Colorado's up 2-1, and the crowd has been enjoying this one. Slides it to Donskoy. Rocked him in the open ice. Sends it out right in front. Nice save by the goaltender to get a pad on that.
But he came out and challenged him. Good save.
Colorado's got a hold of it along the wall. On the attack along the boards. Handles the puck. And now it's grabbed by Dumba. Hangs onto the puck. Here's a chance. Backhander stones him in front.
Quick reflexes. You make one, you make two stops before the puck is cleared away. Grubauer's able to make the save as we see here. This is a good scoring chance, but he's in good position.
The setters will glide into the dot.
Minnesota's won the draw. Oh, what a save by Grubauer. Quick pass to Timmins. Quick feed to McKinnon. Can't connect. Minnesota's got the puck along the wall. Can't keep a hold of it. Minnesota's got control of it now from their own end. Moves the puck. It's a 2-on-1. Oh, smart heads up play to poke that one away. Dumba's been brought down, and we're going to get a penalty here. There's the whistle. And let's hear what the official's explanation on this one is.
You react, you go to get the puck, and you stick your stick into the guy's feet. Down you go.
2 minutes off to the box. Minnesota's got another opportunity here on the man advantage.
They've been trying to push for the tying goal. Now they're going to get an opportunity on the power play.
Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Nice pass. Moves it to Spurgeon. Wrist one in close. Beats the goalie but can't beat the post.
Minnesota's bench has a collective groan here. That shot hits the post and stays out. They're trying to work their way back.
The Avs get a hold of the puck along the boards. Sends it ahead to Calvert. Moves it around along the half wall. Jabs the puck away. The Wild have it in their own zone. Pass back to the point. And he comes up with it. Grubauer's going to hang on and just let things settle down for a moment.
He really didn't have many options to play the puck, but no. In a close game, you want to be sure every time you do.
Minnesota's failed to convert on scoring opportunities, and lots of them here in this third period. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Oh, comes up with a stop. And off the save, that one's redirected out of play. A lot on the line here in this offensive zone faceoff. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Minnesota's got a hold of it against the wall. No one home on that play. The Avs get back to even strength after a huge effort by their penalty killers.
Oh, they're going to rue that one. A chance to even the score here. They didn't get it done. And we go back to even strength.
Past the midway mark of the frame, Colorado's got a slim lead. They lead it 2-1. Faceoff here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. Huge play in his own end to come up with the puck. Here's a short pass to Kadri. Right up front, and that one's broken up. Sends a pass over. Smart defensive play there. Grabs the puck here in the neutral zone. Dumps it in. Passes it to Burakovsky. Knocks the puck loose after a solid hit. Brodin's taking it from his own end. In front of the net, the goaltender covers up for a whistle on the play. A big faceoff here inside the offensive end. Colorado's won the draw and they'll go to work. Bank pass off the boards. Cuts to the front. Stopped with ease. Grubauer's read the situation and he's just going to let it breathe here, Ray.
Well, every once in a while, the goalie will get a sense that the guys are starting to run around. He's been on top of it tonight. Been an excellent game.
Minnesota's offensive struggles have been the story tonight. Lots of chances, just not a lot of results. Colorado's got the puck in their own end. Along the side, here they come through the neutral zone. Minnesota's got the puck in the defensive end.
1 minute left.
Up along the wall on the right side and into the attacking area. Colorado's got the puck along the wall. Less than a minute to go now here in regulation. Landeskog's going to play the puck behind the cage. From one point man to another. And now he tries to get it across to Timmins. Huge steal in his own end. Good defensive effort to poke it away. Minnesota's trailing. That's why they've got the extra attacker out on the ice and the goalie on the bench. And now he moves it to Kadri. Colorado's on the attack. Kadri's got it along the wing. Takes the pass. Stays with it. Hammers one. Denies him on the play. And it's kicked away. Can't catch up to the pass. And that'll do it for ringside here. They were on their heels for most of it, and yet when the dust settled on this one, they pick up a big win.
Even though they didn't have a lot of shots, James, I was kind of impressed with the quality of them. They got into really good shooting spots, and they found enough to win.
Oh, the kids love this part here,
don't
they?
Yeah, they're going to love this, too, because the players, everything slowed down. They come to center ice and salute the fans. They feel part of it.
For Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski. We'll see you next time we drop the puck.